So I am Hiten Bimani from Sri Gajanan Industries, Nizamabad. So the topic given to me was on the challenges and the gaps to increase exports from Telangana. Now, to make any interventions sustainable, we need to ensure a proper ecosystem for the same. For the adequate link between the Indian agri economy to global market, we need to provide an adequate ecosystem for farmers, policy matters, service providers, infrastructure, apart from processors and exporters. Farmers are the actual foundation and they play a vital role in our agri economy, and without making them initial focus, there cannot be a solution. So farmers always prefer to grow crops bought by government, making it safe bet for them to grow, because what happens is, as far as crop insurance is concerned, the claim can be done only if the entire village is affected by the same crop. No farmer takes risk by preferring cash crops or other crops gives them higher return. This in turn has forced the farmers to grow the same crop again and again with no crop rotation, which leads to deterioration of soil as well as increased cost to farmers due to excessive requirements of fertilizers and pesticides. The health of farmer and consumer is also getting affected due to high usage of chemicals and pesticides. Farmers are unable to sustain themselves as there is no significant transformation coming the farmers' way. So the past policies have been a significant reason for farmers following the same pattern. We should look for something of FPO 2.0, where the farmers can come collectively by combining the land, by forming clusters at village level with larger fields. The larger machines would come into play, resulting in low wastage of lands and optimum utilization of resources that will reduce the cost and improve efficiency yield. Collective farming could also result farmers optimizing for naturally grown produce by reducing the usage of chemical pesticides and fertilizers. Encourage research institutions to develop the seed varieties which have international market demand and which can grow organically. India has more than 100 indigenous rice varieties, but they have been branded as basmati or non-basmati rice. We just saw the EPIDA also mentioning non-basmati. So where there is no distinction between the premium varieties and non-premium varieties. In the international market, the terminology what we use is the long grain, the short grain, the medium grain. And for the premium varieties, what we use is the Humali rice, the jasmine rice, basmati rice. But when it comes to India, we have got so many other varieties like Sona Masuri, Chitti Mutti Alu, which has got no branding in the international market. So if we are actually able to promote this sort of brands by exposing this to an international community through exhibitions, this can definitely work out. With so much of technology being involved in food processing units, the units have been reliant on other states of India for primary employment due to lack of skilled workforce. We need to develop institutions that can solve local employment. To order to create Telangana, the district, a hub for different agri-produce in line with one district, one products, service providers like fumigation services, health certifications, phyto-certification agencies, EIA services. This agencies needs to be present not only in Hyderabad, but it also should be present in every district. Because what we see is Hyderabad, everything is, the exports are concerned, is all Hyderabad centric, but it's not going ahead of Hyderabad. generally in Thailand and Vietnam, the turnaround time for an execution of order from delivery to the order to delivery for the shipload is less than 15 days. But in India, it takes more than 45 days. Better performance in logistic is required for enabling India to become part of global supply that can help increasing in trade. Infrastructure is one of the biggest hurdles that has crampled the growth of the logistics sector. The selection of mode of transport or even storage and terminal handling protocols are rarely linked to the cargo characteristics, like the distance of travel, parcel size, and so on. As a result, there is overuse of high-cost modes like road at the expenses of the cost-effective and sustainable modes like railways. Normally, a truck carrying cargo from Nizamabad to Mumbai takes about 2 to 3 days to reach the port. But the export cargo through ICD, if I have to send the cargo from ICD, from Nizamabad to Hyderabad ICD through road and then to port by train, takes 8 to 10 days. Also, there is no provision to carry any refrigerator container by rail. Kisan Rail Initiative scheme for paddy and rice movement by train should be given, which would give business to railways while reducing the road movement and pollution. Rice and paddy has been transported mainly through roads, and our competition country like Thailand transports through waterways, which is much more economical. As a result, their logistic cost is 60% lesser than ours. Telangana is a landlocked state. As it has no coastlines, this limitation can be partially overcome by developing dry ports, increasing rail and road connectivity. While there is one ICD functional at Timapur, one ICD at Sanath Nagar, due to heavy logistic cost to the port, exporters are not competitive. Additional ICDs are needed in the states to decrease the cost and exporters to be competitive in the international market. There is a need to introduce a transport subsidy. For example, rice millers, units located in Nizamabad, Karimnagar, Nalagonda, are currently sending their goods for exports to ports like Vizag, Kakinada, Krishnapatnam and Mumbai by road. And the local millers out there, they don't have much of cost because the port is nearer to them. And we have to send all the way from here to the other ports. That is actually increasing the cost. So for further increasing of exports and to be competitive from Telangana, an assistance from government in form of transport subsidy is required. Due to unavailability of proper infrastructure in loading and unloading points at rail goods sheds and ICDs, especially during the rainy season, there is a delay. Loading and unloading is interrupted due to this delay. The damage is levied on the seller or on the purchaser. And sometimes the vessels also misses due to the delay, and the exporters have to pay huge damages and storage charges. Paddy cultivated by farmers in most states contain pesticide residue at much higher level than the permitted levels as per guidelines of respective countries. Earlier, only developed nations like US and Australia were cautious on monitoring the residue levels. Now, many European countries, including the Middle East countries, have started reducing their residue levels and monitoring their imports. If residue limits are extensive use of pesticides, government should organize awareness camps in every village and also train and appoint volunteers. Availability of testing labs at village mandal levels will increase awareness among the farmers to ensure residue levels in the crops are low. To sum up, the little policies, interventions and additional infrastructure, the primary stakeholders in agri sector, which are the farmers, processors and exporters from Telangana, can be competitive in the international market. In the pandemic time, all the stakeholders have worked hard and even got closer to each other by interacting on regular basis on virtual platform. And now it's time to get in action. Thank you.